हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज द सेकंड चैप्टर फ्रॉम साइंस टू दैट इज साइंस वन दैट इज पीरियोडिक क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट. ओके, सो सी द कंसेप्ट मैप ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. हियर क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट्स, द एलिमेंट्स आर क्लासिफाइड बाय थ्री साइंटिस्ट, डोब्रेनर, न्यूलैंड्स एंड मेंडेलियव. ओके, फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर वी नो देर आर सिमिलरिटी इन the study of these three scientists, that is these three scientists arrange these elements with increasing order of their atomic masses. Okay, this is the similarity in the study of these three scientists. Okay, when Henry Moseley shows the properties of elements are the periodic function of their atomic number, not atomic mass, then Mendeleev further classified elements newly into new periodic chart, that is modern periodic table. Okay, here he arranged elements in modern periodic table into 18 vertical columns and 7 horizontal rows. Okay, in modern periodic table newly, okay, with increasing order of their atomic number. See here, Dobereiner suggests the atomic mass of middle element is arithmetic mean of atomic mass of other two elements. When he arranged elements in increasing order of their atomic number into group of three elements, then he found the atomic mass of middle element was approximately equal to mean atomic mass of other two elements. This law could not be applicable to all elements. So Newland studied these elements and he found every eighth element had similar properties to that of first element. He arranged elements and he compared these elements with octaves found in music. And he found every eighth element had similar property to that of first element. Then there are some limitations in the study of Newland's. This law could be applicable only up to calcium. After calcium, this law couldn't be possessed. This law, okay, couldn't be applicable for these elements, next elements. So Mendeleev studied then this classification of elements. He also arranged these elements into increasing order of their atomic mass. He arranged in vertical groups and horizontal periods. But here in this Mendeleev periodic table, this is based on Mendeleev periodic law. That is, properties of element are the periodic function of their atomic mass. Okay, and here 8 vertical columns and 7 horizontal rows are there. There are also limitations. He could not give fixed position to hydrogen because hydrogen resembles halogen as well as alkali metal. Okay, the isotopes could not be given a proper position in the Mendeleev periodic table. Okay, there is a confusion for placing cobalt and nickel also. So Henry Moseley suggests the proper periodic function of the elements are the atomic number, not atomic mass. Then he again arranged this periodic table into new form, that is 18 vertical columns and 7 horizontal rows. Okay, and here the limitations are there in their study that removed in this new modern periodic table. So this is the concept from this chapter. Okay, so there are some questions that will ask in the board exam. Okay, so important terms means important definition, important laws are there. Okay, so first, Newland's law of octaves. Newland's law of octaves states that when the elements are arranged in increasing order of their atomic mass, the properties of every eighth element are similar to that of first element, those of the first. Okay, so Mendeleev's periodic law states that properties of element are periodic function of their atomic masses. Then the next term, modern periodic law. After Moseley suggests the atomic number is the periodic function, reason for the periodicity. Okay, so modern periodic law states that properties of elements are the periodic function of their atomic number. Dobereiner triads, when elements with similar chemical properties are arranged in increasing order of their atomic mass in group of three called triads, The atomic mass of middle element is approximately equal to mean of the atomic masses of other two elements. This is the important terms. Now, this is modern periodic table. It has 18 vertical columns that call groups. It means 18 groups are there, and 7 horizontal rows are that are called periods. Okay, it means 7 periods. Okay, modern periodic table has 18 groups and 7 periods. Here, this modern periodic table are divided into 4 blocks according to electron configuration. See here, S block, the location of S block contain first two groups, first vertical column and second vertical column. Then P block from 13 to 18. P block starts from 13 to 18. Okay, and between this S block and P block, there is another third block, is D block. It starts from 3 to 12. 3 to, see here number 3 to 12, D block. Then there are two series at the bottom of the periodic table are called lanthanide series and actinide series that make Y block, the last four block, Y block. So these are the four blocks, S block, P block, D block and Y block. Okay, from these four blocks, P block has metal, non-metal and metalloid. Okay, only P block has metal as well as non-metal as well as metalloids. Okay, here this zigzag line separates the metals and non-metals. Okay, then see the next part of the chapter. There is a question, find odd man out. Okay, so see some important questions pick up from that chapter. First, lithium, beryllium, boron, chlorine. Can you guess the answer? Lithium, beryllium, boron, chlorine. See here, the answer is chlorine because it belongs to the third period while others are second period. See in the periodic table, lithium, beryllium, boron, okay, and chlorine. Here chlorine is in third period and boron, beryllium, lithium are present in second period. Okay, the next question, helium, radon, argon, boron. From that, boron is the answer because it belongs, these all elements belongs from 18 groups. Okay, so the correct answer is boron. Then the third question, chlorine, bromine, iodine, oxygen. Here oxygen is the answer because this chlorine, bromine, iodine belongs from halogen family and oxygen is not. Okay, so that is why the oxygen is correct answer. Sodium, lithium, copper, beryllium. Here these are the normal elements. Copper is transition element, that is why we have to find out the odd word out. Okay, then the fifth question, Dalton, Doberaner, Moseley, Newlands. We know this Doberaner, Moseley, Newlands classify the elements and Dalton put forth the atomic theory, so that is why Dalton is the answer. Boron, silicon, potassium, antimony. Here boron, silicon, antimony are the metalloids, potassium is metal, that is why potassium is answer. Aluminium, argon, xenon, sodium. Here aluminium, see in the periodic table, aluminium, argon, xenon, sodium. Here sodium, aluminium, argon and xenon here. Okay, these are the third period elements and xenon is the correct answer. Then boron, silicon, polonium, neon. Neon is the answer because these are the metalloids. Lithium, magnesium, sodium, potassium. Here lithium, sodium, potassium are first group element. Their valence is 1 and that is why the answer is magnesium. Its valence is 2. It means it is present in second group. Chlorine, bromine, arsenic, fluorine. We know chlorine, bromine, fluorine are the halogen family and arsenic is meteorite. So that is why the answer is arsenic. This is the answers. Okay. Here the another question is complete the analogy. We have to find the relation between these two terms and next find out to other answer. Okay. Here Doberaner triad. We know Doberaner, it gives triad law, Newland, Octave's law. Mendeleev periodic table atomic mass, modern periodic table based on atomic number. So that is why the answer is atomic number here. Hydrogen in the first period, hydrogen from first period, lithium from second period. Fluorine, the electronic configuration of fluorine is 2-7 and the chlorine, we know the atomic number of chlorine is 17, that is why the electronic configuration of chlorine is 2-8-7. Group first alkali metal, group first is called alkali metal and group second is called alkaline earth metal. So the answer is group second. Transition elements present in D block, inner transition elements present in Y block. Tellurium, metalloid, radium, metal. Transition elements, inner transition element 3 incomplete outermost shells, and for transition element there are 2 incomplete outermost shells. Lanthanide Ce2Lu and actinide C, the answer is Ts2Lr. Here Ca alkaline earth metal and Cs alkali metal. Cs present in first group, that is why it is alkali metal. Fe electropositive and Cl electronegative. Fe is metal and Cl is non-metal, that is why it is electronegative. Li and A and K. Sodium, lithium and potassium. This is from group first and these are from group 17. Valency of sodium is 1 and valency of phosphorus is 3 because it gained 3 electrons to complete its octet state. Okay, that is why the valency of phosphorus is 3. Okay, next answer the following. See here, write the names and symbols of the elements from the description. Here description is given and you have to answer in one word. Okay, the atom having the smallest size, answer is helium. The atom having the smallest atomic mass, hydrogen. The most electronegative atom, fluorine. The most reactive non-metal, fluorine. Here also given description. The family of non-metals having valency 1, halogens. The family of metals having valency 2, alkaline earth metal, that is group 2nd. Two elements having valency 4, carbon, silicon. Non-metal in the third period, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine and argon. Name the following. The scientists who classified elements on the basis of atomic mass, Mendeleev. The scientists who classified elements on the basis of atomic number, Henry Moseley. The three elements which were predicted, Mendeleev, for which he left blank spaces in the periodic table. We know when he arranged Mendeleev periodic table, then he left 3 blank spaces, okay, for the elements that were not discovered at that time. Answer is Ica boron, Ica aluminum, Ica aluminum. Ica boron, Ica silicon and Ica aluminum, okay. Then the next series of 14 elements placed below the periodic table having atomic number from 58 to 71, that is lanthanide, the upper series, lanthanide. Series of the 14 elements placed below the periodic table having atomic number from 92 to 103, that is thorium to is actinide, that is the last second series at the bottom of the periodic table, that is actinide series. Then another question. Here the 4 blocks are there, okay, and that here points are given to the distinguish them. See here, comparative study of these 4 blocks. We see in the periodic table there are 4 blocks, S block, P block, D block and E block, okay. So comparative study of these 4 blocks from this modern periodic table is given here into this chart. See, The number of shells incompletely filled and valence electron. In S block, outermost shell is incompletely filled. P block, outermost shell is incompletely filled except 18 group. D block, last two shells incompletely filled. F block, last three shells are incompletely filled. Here the valence electrons in S block, there are 1 or 2 electrons are present, and here 3 to 8 valence electrons are present in P block. Position, group 1st, group 2nd and hydrogen. Group 13 to group 17 and 0 group. Here in D block, group 3 to group 12. We discuss this position in this periodic table chart. Lanthanide series and actinide series placed separately at the bottom of the periodic table. Cl includes all metals except hydrogen. Metals, non-metal, metalloid and zero group elements are present in the P block. Here metals and also metals in A block. Types of element. We know S block and P blocks are only incomplete shell, last incompletely filled shell. So this is called normal elements, and the last 18 group are called inert element. D block elements are called transition elements. Their last two shells are incompletely filled. A block elements are called inner transition elements. Last three shells are incompletely filled. Then solve the following for 2 marks this question. See here, X, Y and Z are the elements of a Doberaner triad. If the atomic mass of X is 7 and that of Z is 39, what should be the atomic mass of Y? We have to find out the atomic mass of Y. Here given atomic mass is given for X and Z, you have to find out for Y. Here atomic mass of X is 7, atomic mass of Z is 39. According to Doberaner triad, X plus Z divided by 2, 7 plus 39 divided by 2 is equal to 46 divided by 2, and we get 23. So the atomic mass of Y is 23 because the atomic mass of middle element was approximately equal to mean atomic masses of other two elements. This is the Doberaner law. Then two elements X and Y have atomic number 12 and 16 respectively. Write the electronic configuration for these elements to which period of the modern periodic table do these two elements belong. See here, elements X and Y, atomic number 12 and 16 are given. So the electronic configuration 282, 2 plus 8, 10 plus 2, 12. 286, 2 plus 8, 10 plus 6, 16. So the both these elements belong to third period because the electronic configuration shows the number of shells, that is K shell, L shell and M shell. It means there are three shells, and we know the number of periods suggests number of shells. So that is why these elements belong to third period. Identify Doberaner's triads from the following groups of elements having similar chemical properties. Can you tell? Okay, this is a question from textbook. Magnesium, calcium, strontium, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, beryllium, magnesium and calcium. Okay, these are the three groups are there, three triads are there, and you have to find out they are Doberaner triads, they obey the Doberaner law or not. Okay, so first you have to solve this answer, this question as before we solve this question. Here the mean of A plus C is divided by 2. Here A plus C, that is 111 point, it means 111.90 divided by 2. It gives 55.95. So this answer is equal to or was approximately equal to this answer, this atomic mass of middle element, not. It means which is not approximately equal to atomic mass of middle element. Therefore, it does not form Doberaner's triads, does not obey the Doberaner law. Second example, A plus C divided by 2. Here A, yes, and C, tellurium, that is TE. So the answer is 79.85. Okay, and the middle atomic mass of middle element is 79.0. It means it is approximately equal. Okay, so That is why it formed Doberaner triers. It means it obeyed the Doberaner law. Then the third also solved like this, and we get 24.5 answer. And here the atomic mass of middle magnesium element, that is 24.3, which is approximately equal to atomic mass of middle element. That is why it is also Doberaner trier. Then the next question, deduce the maximum electron capacity of the shell K, L and M. This is the standard formula, Bohr's formula, that is 2N square. To find out the maximum capacity of electron and that a particular orbit, okay. So see here, for K shell, 2 into 1 square, N means the number of shell, that is 1, K means 1. So then electron capacity 2, L 2 into 2 square, 8, M 2 into 3 square, 18, N shell 2 into 4 square, 32. So the answer for this, K shell has maximum capacity of electron 2, L maximum capacity of L shell, that is 8, maximum capacity of M shell, that is 18. Here halogen or group 17 element. Here question is like this, write short note on halogen family or group 17 elements. We know group 17 elements, 17 vertical column is called halogen family. Okay, so you have to write the note, it means point wise. So the first point is, the second last column in the periodic table is group 17, which contains halogen. Then the second point, the members of this group from top to bottom are as given in the following table. Here we know the elements from halogen family: fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, acetine. Then the symbol for this element, F, Cl, Br, I and At. Then the atomic number of this element, you have to write the atomic number. Then the electron configuration of the these elements, and you find there is 7 electrons in their last shell. That is why they require only one more electron to complete the octet state, and that is why the valency of halogen family elements is 1. Okay. Then the third point of the answer, the valence shell of halogen contains 7 electrons. Thus, it needs one electron to complete its octet. Fifth point, the halogen complete their octet and attain the stable inert gas configuration by gaining one electron. Hence, the valency of halogen is 1, and that is they are monovalent. Mono means single, 1. Okay, valent means valency. Their valence is 1, so that is why they are called monovalent. Then the seventh point of that answer, all of them have general formula X2. That is why we have to write F2, Cl2, okay, I2. And here from these elements, fluorine and chlorine are gases, bromine is liquid and iodine is solid. So you have to write this point for that answer, for the short note on halogen family. Then the important question is difference between. The first question is difference between groups and periods in modern periodic table. Groups, periods, here first, vertical columns of electrons in the modern periodic table are called groups. It means in definition point, horizontal rows of elements in the modern periodic table are called periods. Then the second, there are 18 groups and there are 7 periods in the modern periodic table. The group number indicates the valence electrons in the outermost shell. And here period number indicates the number of shells in the atoms of an element. Fourth point, the elements in the same group have similar chemical properties, and the elements in the period exhibit gradual change in their properties from left to right. Okay, the group first element have similar properties, but in period left to right it gradual change. It shows gradual change. Then the metallic character and non-metallic character. Next question. Here, the first point, it is tendency of an atom to lose electron. It means definition point first. Then, second point, metallic character decreases from left to right in a period. And non-metallic character increases from left to right in a period. In a group, metallic character increases from top to bottom. And non-metallic character decreases from top to bottom. Elements having metallic characters are said to be electropositive and they are electronegative. Then the another question, S block and P block. We have to write the difference between these two blocks, and we already discussed the points of these blocks in the compared to study of these four blocks. Okay, so next question, write down the electronic configuration of the following elements from the given atomic number and answer the following question. You have to write the electronic configuration and answer the questions of the on the base on this chart. Okay, so here some elements are given. Okay, and which of these elements belong to period 3, and you have to write the name of element that belongs to period 3. And we know period number indicates the number of shell. It means the element that has 3 shells are present in the third period. Okay, so see here atomic number are given and then write the electronic configuration. So here silicon, sodium and phosphorus has 3 shells, that is why these elements are present or belong to third period. The following table shows the position of 6 elements A, B, C, D, E, and F in the periodic table. Okay, so these are the elements. So you have to write the answer, you have to give the answer from this chart. Which element is a metal with valency 2? See in this chart, which element, the metal with valency 2, here metal, so it is, the answer is D. Second question, which element is non-metal with valency 3? You have to write the non-metal valency 3, B. Out of D and E, which one has the bigger atomic radius and why? Here answer is D, because the atomic size decreases along a period from left to right. Write a common name for the family of elements C and F. C and F present at the last group, that is why they are noble gases. Use your brain power. This is a question for textbook. What is the cause of non-metallic character of element? When any element shows tendency to accept or share electrons and forms negative charge, they are said to be electronegative. That is why non-metals are electronegative, because they tends to gain electron. What is the expected trend in the variation of non-metallic character of elements from left to right? The non-metallic character increases from left to right and metallic character decreases from left to right. Okay, so see, on going through the modern periodic table, it is seen that the elements lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and neon belongs to the period 2. Write down the electronic configuration. See here, electronic configuration. Is the number of valence electrons same for all those elements? No, they are not same. Valence electrons same ahet ka? Valence electrons are same. Valence electron means the number of electrons present in the last shell. So here see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there is a variation in number. Okay, so answer is the no, they are not the same. Is the number of the shell the same in this? Yes, the number of shell are same. Each one of has 2 shells, that is from second period. What are the demerits of Mendeleev periodic table? Demerits mean there are limitations from the study of the Mendeleev. So the first point of answer is no fixed position could be given to hydrogen, because hydrogen resembles alkali metal as well as halogen family. Second, isotopes have different atomic masses but same chemical properties, but the arrangement in first periodic table is on the basis of atomic mass, and that is why the same chemical properties isotopes given in different blocks, placed in different blocks. Based on chemical properties, they were to be placed in same group, while based on atomic masses, they were used to be placed in different groups. Hence, there was no definite place for isotopes. So, there is a question for position of isotopes and position of hydrogen also. The third point, in certain places, elements with higher atomic mass were placed before elements of lower mass. Example, cobalt and nickel. Okay. The some elements with different properties were placed in same group. Example, manganese was placed with halogens, but totally different from the halogen family. The atomic number of beryllium is 4, while that the oxygen is 8, Write down the electron configuration of the two and deduce their valency from the same. Atomic number of beryllium is 4. It is electron configuration is 2, 2. Atomic number of oxygen is 8. The electron configuration 2, 6. It means these two elements has two shells. Okay. And valency of beryllium is 2 and oxygen is also 2, because here beryllium lose 2 electrons and oxygen gains 2 electrons, except 2 electrons. That is why the valency is same. See, write the electron configuration of valency of first 20 elements. We know in modern periodic there are 119, I mean 119 elements are there, and you have to write the electron configuration of only first 20 elements are that. What is the periodic trend in variation of valency while going from left to right within a period? Explain the answer with reference to period second and period third. Here, period second and period third, an element and their atomic number is there. For period 2 and 3, on going from left to right, valency increases from 1 to 4 and then starts decreasing up to 0. Valency increases up to 4 and decreases up to 0 from left to right. How could the modern periodic table remove various anomalies of Mendeleev table? The answer is, we know there are demerits, limitations for the placing of hydrogen and isotopes, okay, cobalt and nickel also, okay. So here that limitation, that anomalies are removed in this modern periodic table. We know modern periodic table is based on atomic number, and Mendeleev periodic table are based on atomic mass. So this is the first point, that the arrangement of elements are based on atomic number, and that is why there are all limitations, all queries or all anomalies removed in this table, new table. So the answer, see the answer, the modern periodic table was classified on the basis of atomic number. All isotopes of the same element having different masses but have same atomic number, and that is why they place in the same block with same similar chemical properties. Here, when elements are arranged according to their atomic number, the anomaly regarding the certain pairs of elements in Mendeleev periodic table disappears. Example, cobalt and nickel. The atomic number of cobalt is 27 and nickel 28. That is why cobalt is placed before the nickel, having both atomic mass, that is 59. Elements are classified according to their electronic configuration into different blocks. So, thank you.